Hi there, I'm Chihiro from Japan. Welcome back to the program. Let's learn a life lesson from a story together. I have feelings for someone. Honestly, it's been tough dealing with unrequited love. We used to go out to eat sometimes, but lately he doesn't contact me anymore. Although I know it's not ideal, I find myself repeatedly texting him. What can I do to move on from this situation? Thanks for subscribing to my channel. Let's get started then. That's the relationship worry of a girl in love. Are there any of you who are in a similar situation? Even though you're not feeling the same way now, I think everyone has had the same experience in the past, don't you? The rules of love and effective email techniques are readily available to look up in this day and age. But will they really work if you put them into practice? The answer is, we never know. It may work or it may not work. Regardless of the answer, I broadcast daily, hoping that everyone's mind become a little more positive. I don't know anything about dealing with love either, but the most important thing is the fundamental part. Love yourself and increase your self-esteem. Continuing to fulfill your own self-love is the shortest path to be loved. Your life won't be improved by learning email techniques. You don't have to work hard to pursue knowledge. Now, let's talk about the differences between men and women. As you all know, men have been hunting since ancient times. So they don't feel pleasant when they're chased after by women. This hasn't changed for a long time and probably won't change in the future. It's imprinted in their DNA. It's instinctual. Wait, what? Hold on. If I don't chase after him, I'll never be able to get him. Is that what you're thinking? Well then, what should you do? The answer is simple. If you keep watching my channel, you'll find the solution. The answer is that you shouldn't leave your happiness in the hands of others. Don't you believe that you'll be happy only if you get together with someone you love? If you believe that way, there is always someone else ahead of you, not yourself. You can find happiness when you're with your partner. However, this alone cannot lead to true happiness. True happiness isn't dependent on someone else. It comes from within. You need to break free from depending on someone else for your happiness. That's where you should start. For example, cherish your friends and family, or try something new and fun that you haven't done before. Immerse yourself in your hobbies or work. Just focus on something and enjoy your time. Spending fulfilling time will satisfy your heart and allow you to love yourself. Then, a happy aura will emanate from you and your charm will increase dramatically. Do you think you're not happy because you don't have a wonderful partner? You aren't treasured by an attractive man? Or you aren't married? Do you feel something is missing in your life? That's why you're not happy. Don't you think so? Even if you don't have a lovely partner, your life is perfect. Yes, it's perfect. Please be aware of it. By spending a great time, you will gradually be able to enjoy your everyday life. Then, even if you're not with a wonderful man, you'll feel happy. You are already wonderful. You're the girl who deserves to be happy. First, you should realize that. Are you okay so far? Ladies, smile. It's all right. You will definitely meet the right person. And if that person is your twin Ray, it's wonderful, isn't it? Regarding the twin Ray, I talked about it in a previous video. Many people may have thought it was a romantic story of love and considered it an ideal marriage partner. However, there is one thing I need to make clear. Twin rays are partners who help learning and growth. I don't get along with my husband. Where's my twin ray? Is my current partner my twin ray? I apologize if you started to worry like that after watching that video. Sorry to interrupt your romantic mood, but let's talk about reality. Twin rays do not necessarily mean a perfect partner who always understands you and has no flaws. We need to understand the true meaning of twin rays. Twin rays are not partners who only provide the good things in romantic relationships. They will not satisfy all of your desires or expectations. We can't avoid difficult things in life. Therefore, while looking for a partner who only gives you joy, you can't find your true partner. Because we have hard times in life, we are able to grow and go on to the next stage. Please make up your mind to accept the negative parts of life. I have a question for everyone. Are you asking yourself these kinds of questions? Why am I not loved? That's not helpful. Why can't I achieve anything? That's not helpful either. Let's rephrase the questions in a different way. What can I do to be loved? That's a good question. How can I achieve my goals? You're doing great. Here are other questions to ask. What are the things I can be grateful for? What are wonderful things about myself? When you ask yourself those kinds of questions intentionally, you will start to have experiences to be grateful for, and you will start to see more and more wonderful things about yourself. Keep asking yourself those questions over and over again. This will help you to turn your life around in a short period and open up a path to better results. live your life the way you want to live it, to the fullest. To everyone who has been listening up until now, I would like to share one good story with you. I mentioned the rules of love in the beginning. Yes, the rules of love. Would you like to know? Let me tell you. Here's what it is. It's called mirroring. I spoke as if it was a big deal, but it's just basic and well-known content that everyone knows. Yes, it's the technique of mimicking your partner's behavior like a reflection. It makes your partner subconsciously recognize that they are similar to you. Speak at the same pace as your partner. Use the same words that your partner uses. Mirror your partner's posture, sitting position, and gestures. When they drink something, do the same, and touch your hair as they do. Mirror them timely, of course, naturally, and without arousing suspicion. By doing this, your partner will think, "This person is on my side. I can trust her because she's similar to me." Without realizing it, your partner will feel comfortable and say, "I feel good when I'm with her." And the psychological distance between you and your partner will get closer. I explained it briefly, but you already know this kind of thing from the beginning, didn't you? You might think, "It's too late if I hear it now." Not really. From here, I will tell you the real purpose of bringing up mirroring, okay? I will tell you something even more important. The biggest reason why I wanted to convey this technique is that I would like you to understand your partner well. Mirroring includes observing your partner carefully. It means getting to know your partner more. I hope you experience understanding and getting to know your partner deeply. If you do that, you will surely be able to calmly perceive the compatibility with your partner based on how you feel at that time. Hopefully this video is helpful to you. Well, that's about it for today's episode. How was it? I hope your life shines even brighter. Let's talk about life, time, Buddhism, love, and many other things together in the following episode. Please subscribe to our channel. Have a great time and keep on smiling. Thank you for listening till the end. See you soon.